This is called the 1089 rule, but I'll be honest, it's more about algebra and less about a rule. So what it says is that we can pick any three-digit number with decreasing digits. So for example, 9, 8, 2, where the digits are decreasing from 9, then to 8, then to 2, or 321, or 632. These are all three-digit numbers with decreasing digits. I can pick any number like that, and then if I reverse the digits, so for example, let's say I pick 742. If I reverse the digits, I'm going to get 247. In other words, I just flip them around. Then I take this result here and I subtract it from my original number. So I take 742 and I subtract that reversed number, 247. When I do that, I'm going to get a particular result. In this case, I end up with 495. Okay, so once you have that result, now what you want to do is reverse those digits again. So I'm going to reverse these from 495 to 594. Then what it says is that if I add these two together, so I take 495, the result of that subtraction, and I add to that the reverse of it, 594, that what I'm going to end up with is 1089. Now, the amazing thing about this rule is that no matter which number I pick, I will always end up with 1089. So I can pick any three-digit number as long as the digits are decreasing. So I could have done this with 982, 321, or 632, just like I did with 742. And as long as I reverse the digits, subtract the reversed number, then reverse the digits of the result, and add these last two numbers together, no matter which three-digit decreasing number I started with, I will always end up with 1089.